What's up, y'all? It's Demajana, and it's time for another one. So, yes, She-Hulk episode 8. One episode away from the finale. And I'm going to be honest with you. I wanted to like this episode. It almost had the feels that a show like this should have had from the jump. Because out of the 8, well, we're going to say 9 because... I mean, technically, we got 9 episodes. So, out of the 9 episodes, we got one episode of her kind of like doing some superhero stuff. I just want you to understand that. It's been one episode out of the 9 that she's been doing some superhero stuff. Like actual crime fighting. This is the problem with this show because, you know, it had the potential because you have a female superhero that is well-liked. And I don't know how you managed to do it, but they managed to do it. They made one of the most liked female superheroes into a trash show. Now, obviously the big cherry on the top is the fact that they had Daredevil in this, which is one of the reasons why I wanted to like this episode. And I will say, the parts when he was in it, was pretty dope. Now, I know you're going to have people say, well, she kind of like... I mean, she is a super-powered hero compared to him. I mean, he has superpowers, but he's not super strength. You know what I'm saying? So, she did get the upper hand on him. Clearly, she's a Hulk. So, I get that part. I get it. That part didn't really bother me. He was still pretty dope as far as like his fighting and all that stuff, his acrobatics. It was dope. I liked it. But let's go over this episode, because it's something about this thing, too, I wanted to mention, too. But we'll get into that in just a minute. So this episode starts out with Discount Kickass slash, I'm drawing a blank on her name in My Hero Academia. Well, I'm drawing a blank on her name, but you know what I'm talking about, the Froggy, because she kind of has that kind of a green suit, right? Yeah, so it starts out with this guy, and he's trash, like a fake kickass, like I said, and whatever. That's how the whole lawyer thing goes on, because he hires Matt Murdock. Matt Murdock's Los Angeles because it was a paid, proceeding. You know, like he said in that show, he usually does pro bono, so that's why he was there. Come to find out, the superhero was doing villain stuff by kidnapping people because he didn't, of course, this whole thing started because of he didn't pay attention to the instructions of his suit. Yeah, that's where we're at too. That, yeah. You're going to see me doing a lot of these blanks because I'm like, I'm still baffled that we are now 8 episodes in and we have one superhero attempt in this whole thing, right? Out of 8 episodes, 9 really, because the way they ended this is like, because we're going to get into that. So, obviously, this is where she goes, and frog guy calls up She-Hulk, talking about he's being attacked by, which she didn't know was Daredevil. She thinking Daredevil's trying to get her, because they, oh, why would I think the person who dressed up like a devil's the good guy, blah, 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 blah. And he's like, oh, I'm Daredevil. And she's like, who? I'm like, how you? I mean, granted, he wasn't part of the Avengers, so he's not, like, well-known, but, I mean, if she's in a lawyer community and knowing anything that's going on, she should know about the heroes, especially since she's a superhero court, a lawyer, you know what I'm saying? So this is him in the suit. I hate the yellow and red. I said that before. I'm not a fan of it. I know that was his original colors back in the day, but not a fan. Red. Okay, MCU, let's bring it back, put him back in the red, or put him with the black, you know, I like the year one black that he used to wear too. That was dope. This is her catching him, taking off the mask, which, again, you know, it was a big deal that, at least in his series, that no one could find out who he is, which I don't like the fact that she found out who he is that fast, but we get it, this is... You only have but so much time in episodes to, tell your story. And he's only in there for, which I would like to see if they bring him back, because technically speaking, he's still there. And I'm wondering if he's going to be, you know, she's going to call him up to defend her, because we're going to get to the ending of this in a minute. So she unmasked him. Oh, and by the way, I see the whole one of the big things is that him not getting realized is the fact that he can be disbarred and all the cases can get thrown out if they find out that he's was a superhero, you know, being that he can see, you know what I'm saying? So vigilantism is not legal, although they have superheroes in this universe. So go figure. So yeah, obviously they start vibing, and of course this is the part that I want to get to. Now, remember how I said I wonder who this show was for, right? So we have nine episodes total. So yeah, 1, 2, 3, 3, 6, 7, yeah. So one third, one third of this series is her smashing a different guy. I mean, I guess if that's what y'all wanna, if y'all think that's what's hot in the streets, but I don't know. I mean, again, who's the show for? Is it supposed to be for for kids? I mean, I don't know. Again, like I said, She-Hulk 80-20, the deal was in the comics. She was the Hulk. There was a bit of eye candy. We understood that, but it wasn't about her smashing. It looks like smashing the hero of the day or the guy of the day in the comics. At least I don't remember that being the case. But at least in this show, it's three of the nine episodes, she's smashing a different guy. And of course, of course they're not going to make Daredevil be the bad guy. But two of the three were douchebags. Speaking of, this is where we get to the icing on the cake. So this whole thing, remember how I kept saying who's the big bad? And it was like, and I said basically the big bad is the patriarchy. So essentially, this incognito, that Intellicognito website, you know, fake Reddit, I don't know what you want to call it on the series, they've had a grudge against She-Hulk, which again, she's been She-Hulk for what? I don't know how much time it's supposed to be within the first episode and this episode, but it can't be no more than maybe 2 to 3 months. How do you get that much hate 2 to 3 months? Again, her introduction to everything was her fighting Titania in the courthouse, right? So they saw her do that one time. Ooh, so that gave her all this hate from one time. It wasn't even like her, the one filming it, somebody else filmed her doing it. Right? It was like, oh, it's on my YouTube or social media, and I'm going to put that up there. It wasn't her doing that. Somebody just saw her doing it. It wasn't like she was, you know, trying to cop fame. Okay, so she get all this hate. But this whole thing, the underlying things, oh, it's the trolls online. It's the trolls online. So, obviously, the last guy that she smashed out, right, I guess he recorded her, because when she's supposed to have her lawyer of the year, which, by the way, they use that to basically, you know, do a stabby stab on the patriarchy again, because, you know, the one lawyer in her firm was like, oh, you got to always ask how it's like to be a female lawyer. I'm like, oh, boy, of course, bro, you got to do this. Why? Why can't we just go one episode? You've been doing so well until you did there. Great. Oh, that's the other thing, too. I skipped something. At least I will say in this lawyer proceedings, because, again, this is like the only... I mean, so you see, so again, that's the other thing. So in the attorney at law show, she's been in the courtroom three times. Was it three? It was the one with Titania came out and destroyed her thing. Then the other one with Abomination, and then this one. Oh, does she have another one? Oh, was the other? Oh, there was the other one where she was helping out the other dude for the Megan Thee Stallion. So out of the nine, she was in four. Not even a full episode. This wasn't even a full episode of being in court. That would have been cool. That would have been an interesting concept of her being in court, you know, more than once if it's an attorney at law. But I digress. That's one of the things that actually was pretty cool, is the law thing. But let me get back to this. So all of this whole time, these guys have had a hate boner for She-Hulk, right? And, you know, her friend was like, oh, they're out to get you. She's like, I'm not worried about guys on the internet. So apparently the last guy she smashed out recorded her. That is revenge corn. I'll say corn, right? It's revenge corn. That's illegal, right? There's no way anywhere that's legal. So they stopped the show where she was getting her award and said, oh, she stole the Hulk's blood. Bro, everybody knows that's her cousin. Like, I mean, are you kidding me? Like, it doesn't make any sense. Here's the other part. So they put this thing up, and this shot I'm showing right now, the in this clip I'm showing, that's her seeing them playing her getting smashed out on film. So that automatically is revenge corn, right? Revenge corn. Again, not legal, right? Especially if she got secretly recorded. She's a lawyer. Here's the thing that gets me that really kind of like grinds my gears. Remember that little speech she gave Bruce? She can handle her rage infinitely better. So apparently, other than her just like, I don't know, I don't know how you could change that situation. Obviously, they're playing it on the big screen. Her parents, I understand she's pissed, but why go rage out, right? But the thing that gets me is that, okay, yeah, she raged out, but it's understandable. I'm thinking if I'm there, I'm seeing somebody got revenge corn on me on the screen when I'm at my award show, I'd be feeling some kind of way. People would understand that. So she hulks out a bit, not gangster. She goes, she sees the guys there with the mask recording her. Again, all this happening, she sees the guys with the mask recording her. Why is nobody else seeing that? Oh, wait a minute. These guys are setting her up. So she grabs one of the guys. And oh, by the way, all while this is happening, her friends tell her, oh, Jen, don't, blah, blah. She's still like, again, understandably, I'd be pissed too. Right? I would be pissed if somebody recorded me without me knowing, putting me on screen, me smashing out, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Especially in front of my parents. That's not something you want to, you know, you don't want to be having that on a, you know, on a, you know, big screen like that, right? Especially if that's not your lifestyle, right? So she rages out. Again, she's supposed to be able to handle her rage a lot better than Hulk. But the thing that gets me is that while all this is happening, right? Yeah, she breaks the screen. She chases after the guy, which she runs through the wall, which I don't know why you had to run through the wall. Okay, but whatever. So now they got you for destruction of property. Whatever. But here's the thing that gets me. They come, like, the cops and everybody's there that fast with guns. Like, it's not like the Hulk. See, when the Hulk rages out, it's destruction. Like, yeah, she broke a TV and ran through a wall. Bad, but not like the Hulk destroying the whole city. You understand? Even though she did mess up a couple cars and stuff like that when she was chasing Daredevil. But nobody was recording that. But yeah. So this is how they end it. And by the way, she like got the surprise face because she's saying the whole time, like, oh, this episode should have been over. And she's like, wait a minute, why is this like... And she's doing her fourth wall breaking. So again, we are now going to be in the 9 episodes. We had one relatively interesting, not saying it was great. This episode was slightly interesting because of Matt Murdock. Again, he gave it a little bit of life, but her not being able to control her rage, these guys that have a hate bone for her, for what? Again, she's been She-Hulk for what? Maybe, again, don't know how long it's supposed to be in their real time, but at maximum 3-4 months, maybe 5, and she got that much hate for that. You know how long it takes to get popular on social media? I mean, I get it. There are some people who can get that quick fame, but we in a world with heroes all day. In the MCU, was heroes all over the place. She's not even a mainline Avenger. And she got that hype? I get it, Hulk's cousin. But that's the other thing, too. How are you going to say she stole the Hulk's power? And they're showing Captain America and stuff like that. I'm like, because that was supposed to be in the MCU, was supposed to be the Hulk project, was them trying to recreate the Super Soldier Serum. So they say, oh, she stole that. But I'm like, oh. Anyway, it just doesn't make any sense. That's the biggest problem with me. Doesn't make any sense. So here we are. We got one episode left. I'm guessing she might call Matt for help. Maybe in the next one. Maybe he's still there. That would be nice if he's still there. I don't know. I'm just shocked. I'm shocked that we're this far. We had 1 out of 9. Out of a 9 episode show. One of those 9 had some relatively superhero stuff. 3 of those 9 was her smashing a different guy. And the rest of it was just a show about nothing. Go figure. But anyway, how did you feel about She-Hulk Episode 8 with Daredevil? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Were you like me? Like you wanted to like it? But then it's like, ah, oh, remembering this is She-Hulk? Let me know how you feel about that. Like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell. If you want to support the channel, you can hit that super thanks. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly.